Cauzality storytelling. This is the feature that caused me to fall in love with Kumu initially, because I could build a relationship model such as this, which is difficult to explain to anybody looking at the picture, but I could go ahead and I could unfold this as a story piece by piece by piece, and I could explain it in whatever manner I wanted to as I unfolded it. And then by the time I got to the end, the person that I was explaining it to would understand all of the pieces and then only be partially overwhelmed by the fact that it's, you know, mind-blowing. So what I came to understand is the amazing thing about Cauzality is it does all that for you, in that in Kumu, you have to define what the loops are. In other words, you make the connections. You have to go ahead and then define this and tell it which connections are part of the loop. In Cauzality, when you create a loop, it knows that you created a loop, and it creates a set of running ants, and then it identifies all of the loops for you over here. Now, when you click on them, you have to figure out what you want to call them. It simply says that it's a reinforcing loop. You have to give it some kind of a meaningful label so that it has a meaning to the loop itself. And I almost always find that I don't know what the story is going to be until after I actually go ahead and build the model and spend time pondering over it to figure out what order it would make sense to unfold this to somebody else, so that once I figure out what the loops are and what they mean, at least one way or another, I can go ahead and move these things around and actually provide them a set of labels that's appropriate to the sequence that I put them in, so that currently they're lined up in an order because I already went through and labeled them. So when I want to explain this to someone else, I can go ahead and say, all right, let's talk about this piece and the way that, oh, and I can bring this into focus. Then I can go to the next piece and bring that into focus, the next piece and focus that, and I can explain the implications of this loop and what it does in terms of the other aspects of the model. So I can walk through it in from piece to piece, and it gives me the ability to do the same things that I do in Kumu with an enormously smaller amount of work associated with it. The other thing that it does for me is, you notice all of these loops down here that don't have any labels? These are all loops that I found out are actually part of this model after I put it in Cauzality and used it to look at the loops. So I have to go back now and look at these loops and figure out what the implications of these pieces are and label them accordingly. And maybe I have to change the order of the story, and maybe I don't, though it's important to realize that I have all of these influences in the map that I didn't know were there, and I may actually have an erroneous perception of the implications of this map and what it's doing because of my limited perspective of what I was looking at. So at present, I'm a real fan of Cauzality. You could probably figure that out already because I'm making all these videos. Spend some time with it because it's just amazing. Take care. Bye.